Welcome to AirTurn and Wireless Switches. Today we're going to look at HelpKidzLearn and how we can integrate some of our old switches with some of this new technology. Blast off with us.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, blast off!
Today we're going to talk about the AirTurn. It's a device designed to work on kids' special needs as far as their motor skills, cognitive abilities, cause and effect, and some just really basic starter skills. So what we see here in front of us is the device that we purchased a while back. What we purchased this for was really the foot pedals. We had a student that was in the music department, and they needed to be able to progress the music. So we use this device in turn with an application called Fourscore. It's a iOS app. Under the accessibility of that app, you can actually magnify the size of music sheets. You can size it up in Fourscore, and then you can also use this AirTurn device to connect to it and then progress the speed of the music that shows up on the sheet. As they're learning how to play, you know, they can hit the right side to increase the speed or hit the left side to slow it down. Well, one thing that came to mind was these two little inputs that were on the top, and really what they do is they turn these into switches, right? And we see on the front here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So really this thing is a 5-button switch with an on and off, a mode selector, and there's a blue indicator for the Bluetooth, meaning whether it's synced or not, and then the power light that kind of blinks. When we unplug the foot pedals here, we see that they're like a stereo plug, meaning each port has two different poles to it. So that means like literally two different switches you could have in these ports. Well, what really got interesting, I think, that I found is that AirTurn started releasing some cables and then also some different products for accessibility. And then they released the actual switch independently by itself without the foot pedals. And you can buy these really cool cables as well. They're only $5 or $6. So in total, this little unit is about $60. It's Bluetooth friendly, and it connects to an iOS or an Android or a laptop, really any device that has Bluetooth. And then from there, you break out the single channels. So you got to make sure you buy the right cable. So we have a left channel and a right. What this really does is it really opens us up to the ability to present it to the students in a very meaningful way using the good old iPad, which, you know, I think pretty much every school or just about every unit has one of these. You know, you can use a laptop too as well. To really start things off, we have our digit. What I found is that we need to be on mode 5. In order for this to work well with the iPad. So in order to do that, we click on the mode button and we'll have it blink 5 times. So I'm gonna press it down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It blinked 5 times back, but the power button was blinking red, showing what step it was on. So it stepped through it 5 times. And then the blue will blink because it's connected to the iPad. But that puts it in a mode that the iPad and software will work respectively together. You can look in the manual, there's definitely a lot of different configuration possibilities depending on software. 5 worked good for the software I'm gonna show, which is HelpKidzLearn. So what we're gonna do, we have this Bluetooth connected, and I can show how we do that. So we have our iPad here. Sorry for the reflections. We're going to turn this on. Right. If you go into the App Store, what you can do is you can download the app called AirTurn. Okay. So all you do is look for AirTurn. and it's the AirTurn Manager. And then you'll hit install. I already have it installed, so I'm going to open it up. And what it'll do is it'll go out and it'll actually find and discover the digit. So it might prompt you to turn on Bluetooth or whatnot, but you just follow those steps. So once it's connected, we can kind of see that we have the AirTurn and we're going to connect to it. So I just click the button there. And then we see that this is the firmware of the unit, and then that's at mode 5. And that's kind of the important part for the HelpKidzLearn software, is if it's mode 5 down here at the bottom, then you know you're set up properly. And to make sure that your switches work, all you have to do is click a switch. So all I'm doing is I'm hitting this. And we can see on the software it lights up, there's the one. Okay, I'm gonna grab this other big button here and I'm gonna hit this, and this is showing the 3, and it's giving an audible beep letting you know it's working. So you could have kids just try this, you know, I mean, really, if they want to hear just noise output, you could do something as easy as that. We opted to try out software that's developed by a company out in the UK called HelpKidzLearn, and its design and main purpose that we found is kids with CVI, so those kids that have cortical vision impairment. What we're going to do is we're going to open up our browser here. So the digit is connected over here, this little guy, okay, and then we have our iPad here, and then we're going to open up our software. So all we do is we open up Safari, we go to helpkidslearn.com. If you have an account with them, you can sign in. And like, here's one of the games that they have. This is more of like a building one. This is more complex than a lot of them, but I wanted to show how easy it is for the two buttons to kind of work together, okay? So if we swing, whoop, we see you missed. You better try it again. Oh, nope, still not stacked up. So we gotta do some building, right? So if we click on the tab here, this is my left stick. We can see I moved a bucket. Say it again, moved a bucket. Try to swing. Oh, nope, still not there. We gotta do it one more. Here he goes. What's gonna happen? He's gonna swing.
Watch this.
Wow.
Nice one.
And again, this is a two-button game. You can do it as a one-button game as well. They give you a lot of different options here. And they, like, the Help Kids Learn website is broken into, at the top here, like, the earlier years, the games, the stories, the creatives, and different things. And you can see the access options. So you can do mouse, you can do one switch. So if this is on a computer, you know, you could use like the laptop's touchpad, or you can use a mouse. So you can see the touch and the mouse. Eye gaze, so if you have a student that is primarily just using their eyes, they could use that as well. And one switch. So we'll go ahead and give this game a try here. We're gonna click play, it's gonna load, and then it's gonna ask which out of those four options we wanna use. And what we're gonna use is one switch, okay? So we'll go ahead and hit play, and we can see that this really basic game opened up. And this switch right here is our number one, so I'll just kind of slide things out. Everything is wireless at this point, except for the switches hooked up to the AirTurn. So all you do is, I'll tell you again, frame here, tap the button. You could hear it give a little audible, like, hey, you should play with me. So we give it a little tap, and there it goes. So it just kind of runs its course, and then after a little bit, it'll reset itself. And now it's doing a different one. Again, we're going to see if the child responds to it. Hits tap. They get that audio feedback.
yeah, this is the Digit BT200. You could find it on AirTurn's website or Amazon. About $60. Again, the cables are about $6 a piece. I found out that if you do use two switches, you'll probably need two cables. It just really connects up very well to the iPad and also to laptops. And then HelpKidzLearn is a software, again, that works on any browser. They do have some downloadable apps as well. Hopefully this helps you in your special education units, and please leave us any comments based on how things work for you. Thanks for your time.